Mindful Life Practice Community.
Some weights, Pilates ball, all the usual stuff. Sorry, I haven't cleaned my apartment with the Halloween decorations. Let's come into a child's pose. Rest your forehead onto the mat. Let your arms be heavy. Rest your hips. Take some deep breaths in and out. This is my favorite song on Taylor Swift's new album. Take your arms over towards the right and stretch through your left side body. And then take your arms all the way back through center and take them over towards the left. And then can you bring your palms all the way back through center? Take a breath in, come up to your table. Nice. In your table today, rotate your palms towards the side. And then maybe they come all the way back towards the knees. And then just rock forward and back so you're stretching through the wrists. I went to a Taylor Swift concert in Toronto. Few summers ago, was my second date with this guy that I met on Tinder, and I made him come to the Taylor Swift concert. Can we rotate the palms around? Lift your left leg up, lift your right arm up, and I pretty much spent the whole night like taking video selfies of myself singing Taylor Swift songs. I was still drinking alcohol at this point in my life. And we didn't have another date. Keep your arms extended, your leg extended, one more breath. And then you're gonna draw elbow to knee and we're gonna do three more. But I mean, it's probably good that we didn't have another date because that was like a preview for marriage with me. Extend your arm. And then can you land your right palm? Let's take our right toes off the side of the mat. Take a breath in. Great, and then can you land your left foot, just lift up. Let's land our left palm onto our left thigh, reach through the right arm, big stretch. And then wrap all the way around, coming back into your table. And then cat-cow again, inhale. And then exhale. One more. Nice, come all the way to neutral. Can you extend your right leg, extend your left arm, navel drawing in, find your balance, breathe in, and then take your elbow to meet your knee. Nice, three more, breath in, and curl. Nice, two more. Nice, one more. Beautiful, let's extend. And then land your left palm, take your left toes off the side of the mat. Inhale your right arm all the way up, finding your balance. And then land your right foot, just lift all the way up, and then let's take our big stretch. And then rotate all the way back through center, planting the palms. Nice, can you tuck your toes and lift your knees an inch or two off the mat and then just float here, pushing the ground away? Nice, and then shift your hips back in space. Three, two, keeping low, nice. And then one to extend your legs all the way up. Bend through one knee and bend through the next, pressing through the heels, stretch out your body. And then leave your left foot where it is, take your right leg all the way up. Can you draw your right knee and step your right foot all the way between your palms? Nice, you got it. Land onto your left knee. Untuck the toes. Lift all the way up into a low lunge. Nice. And then sweep your hands back, reaching back. Nice. Let's just do three of these. Breath in, extension. And then breath out, hinge forward. Two more. Nice. Just take one more. Inhale your arms up. And then exhale, land your palms, frame the foot. Leave your left palm where it is as you reach your right arm all the way up. And then either stay, swim the right palm back to meet the sacrum, or maybe kick the heel towards the hand, taking a bit of a quad stretch. Nice. I'm just going to turn up the music slightly. Stay where you are. Let me know how that is. Nice. And then if you have the foot, I want you to release it. Take your right palm forward and then walk your fingertips back, lengthening over the right leg, and take a few deep breaths, hinging into the hamstring. Nice. Two more. Good. One more. Nice. And then just walk your palms forward. Can you tuck your left toes, lift your left knee, get strong through your left palm, sweep your right arm up. Nice. And then roll onto the outer edge of your left foot, step your right foot all the way back. Let's do four scoops under. Inhale. And then scoop your right arm under. Three more. Nice. Two more. One more. Nice. And then lift the arm up. Land your right palm onto the mat. Nice move through a vinyasa. Beautiful. Come all the way up to your down dog. And then we'll try the opposite side. Take your left leg up. And then can you curl your left knee in? Step your left foot between your palms. You can use your hand to get it there. Nice. Land onto the right knee. Can you inhale your arms up? Nice. And then we'll flow. So breath in, stay. And then exhale the palms forward. Nice. We'll move with our breath three more times. Nice. Two more. Good. One more. And then we'll take our arms all the way up. Frame your left foot. Leave your right palm where it is. Take your left arm up towards the sky. Nice. And then maybe stay here, swimming the arm back, or grab hold of the foot. Take your quad stretch. Nice. Can we release the right foot? Sorry, left foot? No, right foot. Take your left palm forward. Walk your fingertips back. You guys all know what you're doing. You don't need my rights and lefts. Hinging forward, take a few deep breaths. Nice, and then walk your palms forward. Plant your right palm, tuck your right toes, lift your right knee. Sweep your left arm all the way back and up. Yeah. Roll onto the outer edge of your right foot. Take your left foot back. And let's do those four scoops. Inhale, arm up. Exhale, scoop it under. Take three more. Good. Two. Nice. Last one. Good. Lift all the way up. Land your left palm. Find yourself into a plank. Hold strong in your plank. Nice. Travel through a vinyasa. And then we'll all meet up in down dog. And I think we're ready to skip into some quicker Taylor Swift music. From what I remember, her beats per minute are a bit slower, which will mean it will be a bit stronger. Slower means stronger. Can you bend the knees, gaze forward? Step your feet up to meet your hands. Nice. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Good. Exhale, fold. Bend through your knees, sit back in your chair. Good. Take your palms into your heart center. We're going to rotate the elbows. So inhale, stay. Right elbow, left knee. Come all the way through center. Left knee, right elbow. Let's double time. So lift, twist, lift, come back. Nice. Feel a bit of fire building in your legs. Try to keep them bent if you can. If you need a little break, it's okay. Can we do three more? Two more. Last one. Come through center. Lift your arms up. Five, four, three, two, and one. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And then inhale, sweep your arms all the way up. Take your palms into your heart center. Grab hold of your weights. Your weights are going to be facing up. Nice. You're going to bend through the knees, sit back into your chair again with your palms facing up. Nice, beautiful. Keeping your knees zipped together. We're going to pull up the right bicep, pull up the left bicep. So some bicep curls. Maybe doing both at the same time. I love how Tasha's using her yoga blocks. That's great. Stay sitting low. Can you add in the left foot? So as you curl, you step back and take it forward. Nice. And if it's too much coordination, it's all good. One or the other. Doesn't need to be both. Nice. Can we do three more? Oh my God, I'm already so tired from power party. Two more. Nice. Last one. Can you reach your arms up overhead? Keep them lifted overhead and just do some lowers and lifts with the left knee. You've got it. Nice. Four more. Three, two, and one. Stay in your lunge. Sweep your arms forward. You're going to lower your heart forward and then upwards row, keeping the right knee bent. So you're going to pull up and out. Elbows are going to go in this, creating this 90 degrees. Nice work. You got it. Beautiful. Let's just take three more. Two more. Nice. One more. Come all the way up. Place your weights into your heart center. Shift weight onto your right foot. Extend your left leg. Warrior three. Nice. And then can you play with bending your right leg and then extending it? Three. Nice. Two. And then one. Okay, shake it off. We're gonna step through the opposite side or do the opposite side. So step your feet together, weights shift up towards the sky, and then bend your knees, sit back in your chair and start with one bicep curl at a time. So you can do right, lower, left, lower. See that you can see your toes poking out in front of your knees. You've got this. And then can you do both at once? Nice. And then let's start tapping back the right foot. So tapping back and forward. This playlist is pretty much my favorite Taylor Swift songs of the era. This is Red. Three more, two more, and one more. Can you lift the weights up and then hover through that back knee? Nice work.
you're starting to get really tired, like me, remind yourself that you're strong, you're powerful. You got this. This bar class is a third of the way done. Three, two, and one. Lift all the way up. Weights at heart center. Shift your weight onto your left foot. And then can you bend and lengthen? Nice work. Warrior three push-ups. Just take three more. Two more. And one more. Nice. Step your right foot down. Shake it off. Keep your weights in your heart center. You're going to tap your right foot out and in. Left foot out and in. Little bit of movement. Nothing crazy. If you want to circle your arms outward, go ahead. And then potentially join me. Tap, tap, squat. Nice. With steps, it opens. Are your low impact. This is if you want to get your heart up a bit more. Four more. Three more. Two. And one. Hop it out. And how would it feel to just football it out, to finish strong? Three, two, and one. Nice. Okay, take some deep breaths. We're not done yet. Toes out, heels in. Just place our weights on our hips for a moment. Ah, it's our song. When you're ready, we're gonna bend and lengthen. Just starting slow. So you want your knees moving in the direction of your toes. Nice work. Four. Three. Two. On one, bend the knees, sit the hips back and stay. Can you lift one heel and just balance? And land that heel with the opposite one. And then is it possible to lift both heels at once? Floating on the toe mounds, three, two, one, land the heels. Lift the weights up, lift the arms up, 90 degrees. We're gonna close, open. Shoulder press to get in. Sometimes slow music gives the impression that it will be easier. It's actually harder. It's harder to move slow. Can we do three more? More. Nice work. Last one. Press up and lower. Flip your weights so that they're facing towards the earth. You're going to cross and pull back. Cross and pull back. Switch your crossing each time. Put the left hand above and then pull back. Then the right hand, pull back. Do three more. Two. Last one. Place your weights at heart center. Hinge your body forward. Nice. Let's just do our little deadlifts. After this, we're going to take a break from weights, I promise. And you do five more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Take your weights up. Let's finish with a little bit more of cardio. Wiggle your feet in. And now you're stepping out. Hop, hop, squat. Nice, just a couple more. Last one. Okay, put your weights to the side. Grab a sip of water if you like. Oh, what shall we do next? Bad blood, let's do core. Nice, yeah, we're coming down onto the mat. Oh. Let's take, just have our block nearby. We're not gonna use it right away. Come onto your belly, or not your belly, your back. Curl your palms behind the crown of your head. Can you crunch up, tuck your right elbow to your left knee, just stay and hold, and then take it back in. Cross the opposite side, and then we'll double time it. Nice work, yogi bicycles. In every children's story yoga that I do, I'm always like, one day I was riding my bike through the forest, and then we all do this move. So just imagine you're on a nice bike ride. You're not torturing yourself in Barre. Three more of these. Two more. On one, can you tap your right elbow to your left knee and just hold it strong for a count of 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Can you cross and tap the opposite way? Hold it here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 more. Just crossing opposite elbow to knee. We're almost done. 9. You got it. 8. 7. 6. 5. Four, three, two, nice work, and one. Just take your knees in, take your knees wide, lift your feet up towards the sky, just grip your palms onto your feet or ankles, and maybe rock back and forth. Grab hold of your yoga block. Take the block up overhead, lengthen your legs. We're gonna lift up past the block and then extend it forward. Lift the block up, pass it. Nice work, team. Just burning off all the Halloween candy. All the Halloween donuts I've eaten. Thank you, Yasser. Three more, two more, and then one, and then just lower. Take your knees into your chest. Palms onto the backs of the thighs. Can you rock and roll all the way up to a chair? Rocking and rolling the length of the spine. Feet are gonna land, lift your arms up, chair. How we doing? Good. Three, two, and one. Fold forward. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Take an exhale, fold. Oh yeah. Step back to your plank. I just remembered the first time I ever taught this Taylor Swift Barre class. Let's take a little vinyasa. How thematic that I'm doing it this week. Come back to your table. I'll tell you why in a moment. Grab hold of your Pilates ball. So I'm pretty obsessed with Taylor Swift. As you know, land your ball in between your right thigh and calf, and then lift the leg up. So the first time that I had done this Barre class, I had just watched Miss Americana, which by the way is the best movie of all time. Curl the knee in.
open it to the side, curl it back, and lift. So it chronicles Taylor Swift's career. And I have noticed that she really changed her tune from, you know, when I was 15, I started listening to Taylor Swift and everything was like a love song about how some guy broke her heart, right? And she shifted to become very political and very, like this song is called Only the Young, and it's basically was written around the 2000 and whatever year it was, 16 elections, and how like only the young can kind of change things. Do one more and only the young, they have to get involved. Lift up, and then we're gonna do little lifts. And I love the movie Miss Americana because it chronicles her career and it shows that all these moves were intentional. They were all purposeful. When she was a young country star, her agents were telling her, you know, you can't share your opinions. You can't be political because, you know, what happened to the Dixie Chicks and everyone just wants like a nice girl who can sing, you know? And anyway, let's do these little pulses. As she got older, she got more and more strong and confident and started making these intentional moves, you know, to share that she was voting for, not for Trump. And so anyway, it's very topical. I forgot about that, but I went on this rant and the class became named Feminist Barre. Forgot about that. And then I just picked this playlist tonight. This is the week. This is the week. Do one more. Nice work, team. Just land. I kept you there for a while, didn't I? You're doing awesome. Take a few breaths. Let's do the opposite side. Place the ball between the thigh and the calf. Nice. Let's do it. Lift up. Hold still for a moment. Balancing your hips. Nice. And then we're going to move, curl in and open and close. Lift back. Nice work. And then she just still has these classic songs like we're never, ever, ever getting back together, like ever. She's just great. Nice work, team. Let's do four more. Three more. Two more. Good, last one. And then can you lift up and then just do these little lifts, micro lifts. You know who's also a big Taylor Swift fan? Yeah, sir. We bond over our mutual love of her. Do three more, two more, and then one more, and then little squeezes. Nice work. We've got this. So the original intention of Barre was to work your muscles until they fatigue. Let's do that. Just three more, two more. Nice, and then one more. Nice work. Land the left knee. Just take your ball to the side for a moment. We're gonna flip over onto our back. You can keep the ball nearby, but let's just stretch out the right hip. Crossing the right ankle on the left thigh. Maybe interlacing the palms on the shin or the thigh. Getting a nice stretch. And then land your left foot, land your right foot, switch it up, cross the left ankle. Take your nice deep stretch. And then land your right foot, land your left foot. Take your ball, place it between your thighs, push your palms, push your feet into the mat, and then we're going to do some little hip thrusts, lifting up and lowering, holding that ball in place. Ten more of these. So this is working your hip flexors. It's also strengthening your core and your back. Try to have all the muscles engaged as you do this. Five, four, three, two,
and one, lift it up, and then just do little squeezes with the ball, squeezing it in. And now can you hold the ball and then just squish it? Hold it as tight as you can. Legs engaging. Option here, stay in this bridge, or maybe press through the palms, press through the feet, maybe you lift up into your full wheel, just stretching through the spine. And then slowly roll down, all the way back onto your mat, place the ball to the side, knees into the chest. Place your palms on the backs of the thighs. Let's rock and roll the length of the spine again. Coming all the way up into our chair if you can. Nice, can you do it without touching the ground? Good, and if you have to touch the ground, it's okay. That's the super advanced pro way to do it. Stay for 3, 2, and then 1, just forward fold. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Nice, take an exhale, fold, plant the palms. Let's step back to a down dog. Come all the way forward into a plank. Nice, we're gonna do some twists. Step your right foot wider than your hands. Sweep your right arm up. Land your right palm back. Step back, keep going. So left goes wide, sweeps up, lowers, steps back, keep moving. You've got it. Nice work, team. 4 more of these. 3 more. Nice, 2. Last one. Come all the way forward. Come onto your elbows. We're gonna take the right elbow across. Sweep your left arm up. Land your left palm on the hip. Just dip the hip and scooch it up. Nice work. Five. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take your left elbow across, opposite side, hip dips. We're almost into our yoga part, I promise. Just one more. Land your elbows. Nice. Shift your hips back towards the mat. Oh, okay, reach your arms forward. Can you lift the right arm, left leg, and lower? And then left arm, right leg, and then lower. Picking it up, lift, lower, lift, lower. Option here, just start lifting both arms and legs. Nice. And then if you want, lift up, kick and swim. Flutter kick, flutter swim. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower. Take your palms underneath your shoulders. Lift up through a table. Come all the way back to down dog. Keep your left foot where it is. Lift your right leg up. We're stretching it out. You made it. Draw your right knee in. Step your right foot between your palms. Kind of stretching it out. A little bit of yoga as we stretch. Lift all the way up. Land your left heel. Open your arms. Breathe in, reverse. Exhale, come all the way up. Lengthen your right leg. Reach your right arms forward. your right arm alongside your right calf, lift your left arm up.
So you're in your triangle pose. Nice. And then if you want to shift weight onto your right foot, right fingertips, balance in your half moon, go ahead. Great. Can you land your left palm down, lift your left leg up? Standing splits. Nice. And then just step your left foot all the way back on the mat. Plant through the palms. Step back to plank. Either straight back to down dog or take a vinyasa. Left leg lifts, three-legged dog. Pull your left knee in, step your left foot between your palms. Nice, lift all the way up. Open to a warrior two. Beautiful. Take your inhale, reverse. Exhale, come all the way up. Lengthen through your left leg. Reach your left fingertips forward. Left arm alongside left calf. Reach your right arm up, triangle. Nice. And then maybe shift your weight onto your left foot, left fingertips, half moon if you want, or just stay in your triangle. Nice. And then can you land your right palm, standing splits, lift your right leg all the way up. Nice. And then this time just step your right foot back to meet your left.
Forward fold at the front of your mat.
Inhale, halfway lift. Nice, exhale, fold. And then inhale, sweep your arms all the way up, reach the fingertips. Oh, I love this song. Take your hands in heart center. I used to always make people toe tap and plank. We're done with our planks, we're not gonna do that. Leave your left foot where it is. Kick your right heel up towards your bottom. We're gonna stretch our quad. So you either stay just like this, or maybe you lift your left arm up. And then maybe you tilt forward into your Natarajasana, your dancer's pose. Nice. And then lift all the way up. Land your right foot. Let's switch it up. Kick your left heel back. Grab hold of your left foot. Reach your right arm up. And then maybe tilt forward, dancers. You fall, I'm falling all over the place. Nice. And then can you lift all the way up? Land your left foot. Breathe your arms up. Hinge your body forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step all the way back to your pigeon. Right leg up. Draw your right knee in. Lay your right shin across the width of the mat with your left knee back. Yeah, you got it. Lift your heart up. And then come forward. And because of shifting the class half an hour earlier, you don't get to see the sunset anymore, but you get to see a nice little mini sunset. The beginnings. Actually, I pulled out these affirmation cards. I was planning on pulling one out at the start of the class and then I forgot. So we'll just take the one at the top. It says, I am grateful. I appreciate all that I have and all that I've created. Is there something in particular that you're grateful for today? Lift onto your palms, tuck your toes, lift all the way up and back, down dog. Lift your left leg up. Draw your left knee in, nice. Lay your left shin across the width of the mat. Wiggle your right knee back. Take an inhale. Nice, and then come forward onto your elbows. Take one more breath. And then come all the way up. Roll onto your left butt cheek. Come all the way around. Have your left knee flat on the mat, like your left heel in towards your bottom. And we're gonna step the right foot across and then stack the right knee on top of the left. It's a pretty deep hip opening stretch. Cool. This is cow face. Lift your arms up.
Can you land your right palm onto your left shoulder? And then maybe weave your left arm back around. Interlace your palms. Nice. See how that works for you.
You can also grab hold of anything else, your t-shirt, your hair. While I leave you there dying, I'm going to switch the music because it's time for us to cool down.
Take one more breath. And then can you unwind?
Uncross the legs. Rock them back and forth. And then we'll switch the opposite way. So land your right knee down first. Step your left foot all the way across. Lift your arms up.
Left palm on the right shoulder. Right arm sweeps all the way around. Hook your fingertips together. If you can, or grab your shirt or your hair.
I'm so, so grateful for this community. I look forward to these classes all day. It's my favorite part of the day. Uncross the arms. Uncross the legs. Slowly roll all the way onto your spine. And then just leave your left foot planted, reach your right leg up towards the sky, interlace the palms on the back of the right thigh, and then maybe you extend the left leg. Maybe reaching the palms further up the leg to get a nice hamstring stretch. And then we'll switch it up. Land your right foot. Lift your left leg up, interlace your palms on the thigh, maybe on the shin. Maybe you extend the leg. Then can you land your left foot back down? Open your arms, take your knees in. Drop your knees over to the right, land your right palm, gaze over the left shoulder. Open the right arm. Lift your knees up through center. And then switch the opposite way. Land your knees, gaze over the shoulder. Come all the way up, knees into the chest. If there's any last poses or any last shapes that would seal your practice, please choose them now. yourself either into a savasana or a seated meditation. Allow the last few moments of every class to be a container to hold you. Also a final opportunity to just let go. Shavasana was originally corpse pose. Or not originally, that's what it is. That's what it translates to. And what it signifies is an ending, right? An ending to shed or to let go or to release whatever you need to let go of, whatever's not serving you. So that at the end of this practice, you can walk away reborn and refreshed and renewed. And try to completely let go of everything, let go of your cell phone, let go of your to-do list, let go of all of the things that are in your brain. Just know that I'll bring you back when the time is up.
our song is the slam of screen doors, sneaking out late, tapping on your window. When we're on the phone and you talk real slow, cause it's late and your mama don't know. And our song is the way you laugh. First day met, didn't kiss her, and I should have. And when I got home for a sad amen, asking God if he could play it again.
Just give a wiggle through your fingers and your toes. Take a nice long stretch, fingers all the way through toes. Nice. Take your knees into your chest. Give your body a big hug. And in this hug, thank yourself for showing up. Acknowledge your effort. You made it here. And that is all that really matters at the end of the day. And slowly make your way up to seated. Taking your palms at heart center. And we will wrap up with our intention. And our intention is that our practice remain steady and our efforts remain continuous. Our yoga serves and benefits not just ourselves, but all beings everywhere. May all beings be safe and be happy and be healthy and be free. And may the thoughts and actions of each of our lives contribute towards this. So finishing with a sweet little om, taking a breath in, then a breath out, and a breath in. Om. Thank you so, so much for sharing the space and the practice, the light in me. It sees and honors the light in you. Namaste.